Hey guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits, and today I'm going to show you why your presets suck. That's right, we're going to dive in and I'm going to show you why they aren't working the way that you thought they would when you bought them. Let's dive in. Have you ever had this happen to you? You find some awesome photographer who sells presets, so you buy those bad boys, find a photo to develop, and you hit those presets. And they just look like crap. Has that ever happened to you? Because if so, you are not alone. I have been there and spent way too much money on presets that didn't work. Let's jump in, look at a few photographers' work, and see why those presets aren't working for you. And I'm going to give it away right now. The reason your presets aren't looking the way you want them to look is because the photo that you're working with isn't what those presets were designed to work with. And so let's head over here to some photographers. Let's take a look at their work and see what I mean. So this is Mr. Daniel Hahn. He takes awesome landscapes, and I want you to look at the lighting and the composition of these photos. You're going to notice something. It's consistent. Every single photo, we have a brilliant composition and fantastic lighting, and that doesn't change. The photos where the lighting is less than pleasant, you're going to find the tones are less than pleasant. The edit doesn't look quite as consistent. It doesn't have that wow factor of a well-composed and well-lit image. That makes every difference, guys. And you're going to see that no matter what genre we go into. Let's go over for India Earle. Let's look at her stuff. She does weddings, portraits. Those of you who do the same thing, you're going to notice in her photos, 99% of them were taken with fantastic light and they were well composed. So by that, I mean the light is not harsh. We don't see any dark shadows on the ground beside this couple. Why? Because we've got this nice fog bank behind them. Or other photos we've got taken at sunset or with overcast skies. They're all taken at sunset, sunrise, or on a cloudy day when the light looks awesome. And you'll notice the photos that don't look as awesome, well, it's because the light wasn't as great or the composition wasn't as great. Let's head over to another photographer, Dylan First. He's the master of moody blues, okay? So this guy is crazy consistent in his Insta feed. It's on point, and you will notice one thing. He only features two colors, blue and green, and occasionally a pop of orange. And I want you to notice something about these images. It's not looking this way because he has some Bala preset he puts on there and it magically fixes things. No, it's because when you actually think about this image before it was edited, we had green trees, we had a green-blue lake, and we have an orange dog. And you know what happens after he edits it? There's a green trees, greenish blue lake, and orange dog. And you're going to see his work is so consistent. And the photos that aren't super consistent, where we do have these other tones, other images, and other lighting going on, this is a little bit harsh. We've got some harsh shadows here, and it just doesn't have the same vibe. So if you're looking to get your photos a specific look or vibe, you've got to think about the composition and about the lighting. What colors are present? What distractions are there? Because when you look at these awesome photographers, you'll find that they get rid of distractions at all costs. We've only got this couple in this photo, couple in the photo, couple in the photo. We don't have, you know, a man selling ice cream in a truck in the background that's taking away focus. When we go to Daniel Hahn's stuff, we have one central focus most of the time in his images. And the photos that don't have that central focus, well, those aren't the wow shots. Let's head over and look at Queen of Jetlag's photos. And hers are awesome. She's a very talented photographer. But you'll notice something very important here. Some of her photos don't have that wow factor. So for instance, let's take a look at this one. Wow, what a beautiful image. And why? Because we have a very consistent color theme here. We've got pinks, oranges, reds, that's about it, and her in the front. Okay, there's no distractions taking away from this photo. Everything is pointing towards her and adding meaning to this photograph. Now, if we look at a photo that's taken more a little bit, you know, blogger style, just something random hanging out photo, this does not have the same effect. Why? Because we've got competing colors in the background. We've got greens, oranges, blues, purples, reds. We've got this napkin, fork, knife, cups. All these things are detracting from the photo. There isn't the same focus and symmetry and composition and color. In addition, we've got really harsh light. This was taken probably in the middle of the afternoon when the background is very blown out. We've got some harsh shadows, and it just doesn't have the same look. So that's it, guys. If you are in Lightroom and you're finding that your presets just look like crap, it doesn't work, well, the first thing you should look at is what photo are you working with to begin with? Does your photo have really harsh light, or was it taken on a flattering day? Do we have tons of different colors going on and really dark darks and greens that are going to make the skin tones look funny? Or do we have a beautiful flattering photo? So let me just show you this. We've got these presets here, and they all look like crap on this photo. Why? Because it was taken with really harsh light, and so we're going to have to play around a lot to fix this and get it to a place where we like the way that it looks. Okay, so I could do some different things here, play with the contrast, maybe bring my shadows up, It's not looking awesome. I'm going to be honest. It just doesn't look that great. Now, if I head over here to another photo, very similar. I mean, it's a portrait at the same time, but you'll notice, look at their skin tones. We don't have the harsh shadows going on in this image that we did in our first shot. It's taken on a sunny day. However, they're in the shade. So the photo is so much less busy. We don't have the distractions of the flowers all around them. And we also don't have those green leaves reflecting on their skin. So their skin tones are a lot better. Now, when I apply presets, look at that. They all look great. Same presets, totally different result. So if you are wondering why your presets suck, take a look at the photos themselves. Work on mastering the basics of your photography, your color, your lighting, your composition. You'll find once you start mastering those things and improving those things, your presets magically start to get better. Who would have thought? So that is my tip for you. If you are editing in Lightroom, you want to take your editing to the next level, the first thing that you should focus on is, are my photos at the top level that they can be? I hope this was helpful for you. Please, if it was, hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you want some free Lightroom presets, check them out in the link below. I'll see you in the next one.